And I realize how difficult these cases are. What are the most important documentation or any evidence or, like things or papers that they have to submit to be able to prove that they have a strong political asylum case, Attorney Golan?
Oh, very difficult. Legally, political asylum is divided into five subcategories. There are five subcategories, and your application must fit into one of those five subcategories. Recently, during the last year or two, the administration narrowed very much those categories. So if the categories were much wider, now they are much narrower. For example, previously, people could apply for political asylum even if their persecution was completely non-political, but was based on some kind of family situations. And now this is out. You cannot do it anymore. Now, if you claim you belong to any of those subcategories, for example, you have a fear of persecution in your country because of your political opinion, you must prove it. You must have proof that the government really intends to cause you harm or already did in the past caused you harm. So you need to have documents to prove it, which is very difficult and getting more and more difficult.
What does it mean when they have an approval for their political asylum case? Will this change after a year because of certain new evidence that they find out, or is this something like really towards approval of their application?
After 1 year, if anybody who is approved for political asylum may apply after 1 year, may apply for adjustment of status to get a green card. However, at any time, almost at any time, the government can claim change of circumstances in the home country. For example, if the president of your country changed and instead of being a devil became an angel, then they say, okay, the circumstances changed, now you can go back to your country. So this is a possibility. It doesn't happen very frequently. More often the angels become devils instead of the devils becoming angels, but it may happen sometimes.
And what happens to let's say, the ones who are left behind? Let's say if they had children who are overage, over age 21, will they be able to join their parents too, because of the political asylum case that has been approved?
Not really. Spouses and minor children, minor unmarried children, may join a parent or a spouse who was granted political asylum, but not adults.
And how quick, is the processing of the adjustment of status, Attorney Golan? As you mentioned, they can apply for adjustment of status. Do they look at this as a priority basis?
No, nothing is today on priority basis. Usually, almost all applications are being delayed. This is part of the system now to cut on immigration. The government is doing everything slowly and even more slowly. And anybody who files for adjustment of status, even if by marriage to an American citizen, may expect a wait of about a year before the application is adjudicated.
So that means there's no longer a priority processing where they pay a little bit more fees to be able to accelerate their case?
Premium processing for adjustment of status. There
I
was
see.
premium, there was, there is premium processing for the other types of petitions, but not for adjustment of status.
That means that for the other immigration categories, there's still the premium processing fee.
For some of them, there is premium processing. On the other hand, they even make some immigration procedures even more difficult. For example, EB1. There is a category called EB1, And this is a category which does not require a labor certification and does not require a job offer. You don't need to have a prospective employer, and you apply based on the extraordinary ability that you have in the science or arts or business, okay? And this was a very popular category for people who are like outstanding athletes or outstanding scientists or people with great success and reputation in the business community. Now even this is becoming very difficult,
mm-hmm.
because the immigration service is raising lots of questions and sometimes very unreasonable questions for such applications, and probably between one quarter and one half of them get denied.